Zoom up, Jig. Pick it up. Ala. Ala. Who's is this? Yeah, whose camera I got? Whose camera is this? Here you go, Archie. Yeah. He's still on. Who's just this?
I don't know. Who down here too?
I think maybe Crawford's. I don't know. I'm not sure who's. I think it's his.
This is Scott's.
Yeah.
Scott holding the whale all by himself.
Holy cow.
He went fishing and caught one hell of a big one.
On the fire, 28 footer.
23 footer.
23? 20.
Somewhere around there.
Yeah.
24.
28.
24 foot. 25.
Oh, wow. Come on, it's a fish story. It's 25 foot in between the eyes, man.
So, you're going to go with Chupa, you and Robert? The ceasefire.
Yeah.
Okay.
Now they're tying the tallyhooks together. And they'll be towing it down north towards town where there's a more solid ice. There's a Petkudex boat. Yard boat. Petkudex skin boat. Hey Scott, how are you doing yourself?
Red butt. Who's that? Harry? Hey,
hi.
I don't know.
Leroy, they're going to meet you here.
Fuck, man.
Dead person, you sure don't know who to call.
You get the gun? Chuko.
Chuko, what are these, man?
Leave him here, I'll say next. Now that's some good film.
Not that well. Roxy to the rescue. Chuku scared away. At least the bucker duck's got theirs. They're thinking of staging right there. And that way they can launch off there because they usually come up breathing right over there. Come on, guys. We got Robert the Elder and everybody. Good guys. Cow. Checking us out. It's right across from us. What size do you think that is?
Maybe 8-9 feet. 8 feet maybe.
It's checking out the boat. It sit down. Oh, it's checking us out. looks fat. Come on, go away. Yeah, here I am. Enjoying your diet. Jump in that water, I'm out of here. Elbows and heels is all you'll see from me. Go away.
Yeah.
Seen my movement. Wonder if it's contemplating swimming over there. No, it looks too tired, it yawned. Must be night time. I don't know. I'll put it night-night. Give it some lead poisoning. Cool. Only one hunting group at a time. Looks like it's in punks. Gotta be sure it doesn't go back towards camp. One a day is enough. Gone, it's getting close. Another one come to visit. This one's bigger. Hey, that bear.
Just is it like blade in the water or something?
Is it
Now,
where is it? Oh, you got some duck book?
Yeah.
Oh, you got some duck book, huh?
Yeah. Yeah.
You got some duck book?
Yeah.
Wait, wait. Kulak, fish you. You know me?
Careful under you. Careful under you. Underneath you.
Should I tell him?
Yeah.
You got some duck book?
Over here.
Wait. I'm a duck book.
Come on!
Hey!
I'm gonna
go back to the
house.
It's going. Lung boat.
Yeah, I look at lung boat.
Lung boat for you.
Archie, let's look at the lung boat. Gina! Go get the lung boat.
No.
It's gone.
Is it our rafa?
Yeah.
Show me how much you have.
Damn it, show me where you took.
You can't be around here.
Help him! Help him! Help him!
Just let it go.
Why are you feeling let go?
God, get away from that area.
Woohoo! Shh, don't say nothing, man.
Ivic.
Yeah, I'm gonna go on with Colorado. You would say Zuda.
Okay. 18 after 11.
None bought it, come there.
The boat.
What thing?
To make that.
Big rope right there.
Yeah. Oh. To put them.
Build down.
So you can put them like two holes and put them together. Yeah. Like two holes meeting.
That guy is so crazy.
Walk away.
Are they gonna put it now?
No, they got it in the house.
Pull the whale in. Yeah, there you go. Yeah. We got the horns over here.
Here it is.
Oh, you guys.
somebody to take care of it. Holy.
Oh, recording.
I don't even know how much tape I got left in this thing. I'll just keep going.
Oh, let's put that tape in there.
Yeah, somebody.
That's true. Come on.
Pull it.
Whoa! Dad! I'm not gonna die tonight.
Did you you to cut deeper on these.
How many feet?
That's true. They took a rope. They're going to go measure the rope, I think.
They measured with a rope?
Yeah, and then they'll go measure the rope.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, they tied a knot in the end.
Oh, you're coming?
Yeah.
I can hear us.
Yeah, it's okay.
How are
we? Hey.
Ah. We did quick today, huh?
This is my first whale I ever helped participate in hunting.
Oh, yeah?
I witnessed yours and then we even got this one. Yeah. Yeah.
We were together too over there, only us, huh?
Yeah. The hook runners, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Hookers! Hookers! Come on, hookers!
Make sure you get the quick one.
Would you know how many? Something to me.
Two or three, whatever. That's
good.
Get out of here.
How many big brothers around here?
About 26 and a half feet.
Yeah.
26 and a half.
26 and a half, maybe.
Jason sleepy.
Hey Juku. Juku. Juku.
Oh yeah, we got some in the bomb box.
Hey.
Run over, Nate. Run over, Nate.
that's just what he both.
Nolly.
Cutting the eardrum out, huh? And that's our captain. Cool. Yeah. One day when we get old, we'll need a hearing aid. That's what we'll use. Got a minute, Rex? I gotta talk to you.
Billy.
I got something for you. Crazy guys.
Scott, here's the headroom.
I'm right here.
Wow.
Never think this bad.
That's my mom making okra clock duck. I mean dough for okra clock duck. Today is May. What's today?
Shaluk Nai. Shoulder Evon Stephen Peter Oji. Vashrank Ogotanitli. Za Gichi Genjit Shoitli. My name is Evon Peter. I'm the chief of Arctic Village and the Alaska chair of the Gwich'in Council International. I'm very happy and honored to be here and be able to speak with all of you today. Before us, before we were standing here, there was a man named Moses who stood up for his people. There was a man named Gandhi who stood up for his people. There was a man named Martin Luther King Jr. who stood up for his people. There was a woman named Elizabeth Paratrovich who stood up for her people. Today we have gathered here because it is time for our people to stand and to see clearly and truthfully what it is that has impacted our people throughout history and that continues to impact us today. And we need to stand together, united, to overcome the challenges that are in front of us. And I believe that we'll be doing that. From the time that the Western peoples first came to this land, when the Russians came up and enslaved the Aleuts for the sea otter pelts, to the time that the US government came and did some sort of a negotiation and sent their military convoys through the state to assess what type of a military role our natives might be able to play to stand against some sort of domination and oppression. To the time that my grandparents could not buy land or shop in the stores in this state, to the time of the Alaska Native Civil Rights Act, to the passing of the Alaska Native Claims Settlement Act and ANILCA, and to this day, the history of the story of the treatment of Alaska Native people has been one of oppression, racism, exclusion, and attempted assimilation. It is time for us to stand to change this story. We have come here gathered today not because of some urban-rural issue. We have come here to stand our ground for the human rights of our indigenous people to continue our way of life. There are certain things in this world which are uncompromisable. For us, this is our language. This is our culture. These are our traditions. These are the relationships that we have with the land and with the animals and with each other. This is being human. This is having a spiritual foundation. These things we should never be willing to compromise, and no people should ever have the right to govern us and to regulate us in a way in which they would try to strip us of these things. I believe I've been watching and listening to the movements among the Alaska Native community for many years. We began with the sobriety movement in the 80s when it took hold and our leaders became clearer thinking and became really able to see and unite with each other to confront the challenges we face. We have progressed a long ways. I believe that today marks the true beginning of the spiritual movement of our people to become well and to be truly self-determining as far as how we are going to live and what the future of our people is going to look like. I would like to ask everyone to repeat a few things after I speak them. And I want everyone here to speak it from their heart and to say it as loud as they can and to raise their fists in the air when they do. Now repeat after me, please. We the people. We'll stand our ground to end this oppression, to overcome the greed, to set our people free. May the Great Spirit bless each and every one of you and keep you strong and wise as you work to help our people and all people become truly self-determined and spiritually well once again. Merci.
He's a beautiful representation of the young generation that is going to replace us one day. It's my honor to introduce the next guest who came all the way here from New Mexico. And he, you would know him when you see him. He gained worldwide fame in his role in Geronimo and The Last of the Mohicans and Dances with Wolves. Among many other things, he's also the author of the Billy Bean children's books that comes from his heart to the children. Let us welcome him here to Alaska and show him an Alaskan welcome and love. Wes Studi.
OCO, OCO, that's the best Cherokee greeting I ever heard outside of the state of Oklahoma. Thank you, yes. It's an honor to be here. I'm Cherokee myself, northeastern Oklahoma, and I think, in my opinion, on the issue of subsistence, the people have spoken. The people have spoken. As a Cherokee from the lower 48, I understand what it is to lose your rights for hunting, fishing, subsistence rights, because we have lost ours. We're slowly gaining them back, but it is a slow process. So in a way, I envy you people here in this land that is developing at this point. I've just been told that there are no fish, there are no moose. At a certain area where this lady is from. This is a sad thing. Yes, yes, it's a sad thing when there, what happens is that when there are more people than there are renewable resources, something has to be done. And I think this may be one of the first steps toward resolving that issue. And as a fellow indigenous, I wish you the best in this effort. And with a turnout like this, I'm sure that you will be able to achieve that which you need to achieve. Again, I want to say it's very good to be here and to see that those of us who are indigenous to the Americas are fighting the same battles. I say I'm glad that we are fighting them, but I'm also sad that we have to still be fighting the same battles that we have been fighting since, as far as we know, the beginning of time, in terms of dealing with federal, state, and municipal governments. This will never change. This will never change in terms of having always to protect your rights. We will always have to achieve and continue to protect the rights that we gain. We must always ever be vigilant to hold those rights so that we can practice our cultures in the way that they're meant to be practiced, so that we can practice our ceremonials, our religious beliefs, in the way that we have always done so. So with that said, I think that you will achieve what you have set out to achieve here. It's time that state and federal governments begin to work with those of us who have lived upon the lands that are being used by all of us now. We have to learn how to share that which is given to us by the Creator, the lands and the renewable resources that these lands provide. The lands must also be given time to rest in order to continue to reproduce. And this reminds me of the last time that I saw my father. His last words to me were, "Listen to your mother. Do what your mother says." And this extended far, far, far beyond my own biological mother. We are a matrilineal people, always have been, and will continue to be so. But what he was telling me was to listen to your mother. Your mother. She knows the way. She's been there, and you most certainly would not be here were it not for her. Of course, the process isn't so bad either. It's a beautiful day in Anchorage, Alaska. I feel like I have formed a stronger brotherhood with indigenous people to the north. This is my first time here. The people have spoken. The people have spoken, and it's time for state governments, federal governments, to begin to listen to what we have to say. And I know that you as a people will stand up and speak your mind. That's the only way. That's the only way you're going to get what you want. Speak your mind. Thank you very much.
And just at the very appropriate time, I mentioned that we are going.